In this video, we're going to look at the root test. The root test is very similar to the ratio test. The only difference is, in the ratio test, we were taking a ratio of a sub n plus 1 divided by a sub n, the absolute value of that. Well, the root test, instead of creating a ratio like this, is we were taking a root, like a square root or a cubed root. And so that's what the little nth means. And so all of the criteria here for convergence are the same. If rho is greater than or equal to 0 but less than 1, then the series converges absolutely. So this is also a test for absolute convergence if it's an alternating series. It diverges if it's greater than 1 or infinity. And if it's equal to 1, once again, the test does not provide any information. All right, so let's take a look at the first example. So here is our series. Now, how do you know that you might want to even use the root test? Well, in this particular case, you notice that the numerator and denominator are both being raised to the nth power. So if you've got a situation where you've got terms like this that are being raised to the nth power, you can simplify it by raising all of that to the nth root. And so that's exactly what we do here. So rho is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the original series. Well, remember that the nth root becomes something to the 1 over n power. And so basically all of the nths cancel out. N squared plus 3n to the n power to raise to the 1 over n power, the power raised to a power ends up the power is equal to 1, and the same thing with the denominator. So we just end up with that. And so that's easy enough to figure out what the limit is, and it is 1 over 4. So rho is 1 over 4, which is less than 1. So just like with our ratio test, the series converges absolutely. In the second example, pretty much similar idea. We have this fun-looking little function. And so we notice the numerator and denominator are both raised to the n power. And so we take the nth root of everything. And so then I'm rewriting it this way. So it's a little clearer to see. Taking the numerator and denominator here, and just combining the numerator and the denominator, raising them all to the nth power, which is then being raised to the 1 over nth power, and power raised to power, those just end up being equal to 1. And so we just end up with that. And so a couple ways you can do this. You can do this intuitively, taking the limit of this. N is an increasing function, log of n is an increasing function, but n being a linear function is going to increase faster than the log of n. So the numerator is increasing towards infinity faster than the denominator, so it's going to be infinity. Or you could use L'Hopital's rule, take the derivative of the numerator and denominator. The derivative of the numerator is 1, the derivative of log of n is 1 over n, 1 divided by 1 over n is n, and so clearly, as n approaches infinity, n approaches infinity. So therefore, infinity is greater than 1, and the series diverges. The next one's just a little trickier. because it clearly looks like not the entire denominator is raised to the n power, right? So we're still going to attempt to do this by using the root test. So we take the nth root of everything, and we rewrite that as, and you can just skip this stage right here, just go right to this. I'm just showing you all the steps so that you see what's going on. Now, 3 to the 1 plus 2n, we've done this a few times before. This could be broken up into 3 to the first times 3 to the 2n. And so this is basically, three times 3 to the 2n in the denominator, and you have the n to the nth in the numerator. And so what I did here then is raising everything to the 1 over n power, the n to the n raised to the 1 over m just gives you n. 3 to the 2n raised to the 1 over n gives you 3 squared. And then 3 to the 1 over n power gives you 3 to the 1 over m. So this is a little bit different. And so the 3 squared in the denominator is just not 9. So it's basically you could put the 1 over 9 out here. Get rid of that. Don't look at it. So you basically have n over 3 to the 1 over m. Now, you could try taking the L'Hopital's rule, the derivative of the numerator, the derivative of the denominator, but it gets kind of messy, because remember, derivative of an exponential with a base that is not e, you have to multiply by the log, so the log of 3, plus you're going to have to use the chain rule for the 1 over the n. So it's probably a little bit easier to just kind of do this intuitively. N is linear, 3 to the 1 over n, or you could just graph both of them, graph both these functions, see which one is getting bigger faster. And 3 to the 1 over n is the same thing as 3 to the negative n power. And so 3 to the negative n power is an exponential function that's getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, like that. Whereas a linear function is getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So basically, the numerator is getting bigger and bigger. Denominator is getting smaller and smaller, so the whole thing's just getting closer to infinity. All right, so therefore, the series diverges once again. And so that's pretty much what all there is to the root test. The root test and the ratio test are both really nice tests to use for more complicated looking functions. The root test, if you've got numerators and denominators all being raised to the n power, use the root test. With the ratio test, it's helpful when you have factorials. If you have factorials, then you want to take a look at the ratio test. All right, that is it for this video.